Yo, 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 everybody. What is up? We are live, coming to you from Skinny Bob's Classic. It is not a race tonight. I got to get the race length, but I got to play some music. I'm going to say really quickly, we get comments on almost every video, and I try to do my best to let you guys know. People say something to the effect of, there's absolutely no use for the music. We don't like it. We have to play it, guys. We have to play it. The venue is playing copyrighted music, and in order for YouTube to not pull the video down, we need to play some non-copyright music that we pay a subscription fee for in order to make sure that you guys can watch the video. So please, I hope you understand. Try to do my best to get kind of a range of music that's got a chill vibe. But anyway, now that that's out of the way, excited to watch Fedor go to work here at Skinny Bob's Classic. They are playing 9 on the spot. I don't know. Skinny Bob's now a ranking event? Let me go look at Digital Pool to make sure I got all the info right on the event, and then I'll open up the chat so I can make sure that I'm not missing anything that you guys are saying. But I just got here just a little bit ago here at Hard Times to get the stream ready. So trying to get my head on straight. Oops. This is the first rack. They just lagged. Looks like Fedor won the lag. Holy crap. How many balls did he make? Looks like the wing ball's throwing down. Two ball in a rough spot. Three ball dressed up over the pocket nicely, so it actually makes it tough to play safe here. Skinny Bob's 9 Ball Classic. The second annual. $150 entry fee, 128 player limit. Races to 7 on both sides of the bracket. We're on round 2 right here, guys. Fedor's already won his first match. He was playing fairly early for me. I actually had to take care of something for work this morning, so I wasn't able to stream that match for you guys. Okay, I think I'm squared away. Let me get the chat up so I don't miss anything that you guys are talking about. It's happening. What's up, Winston? Welcome, welcome. You think the guy he's playing looks like Mr. Beast? Nepa BMX says. I don't know about that one. It's good to see you too, Will Totten. Where's this happening at area-wise? So it's happening in Texas at Skinny Bob's. I forget exactly where that is. Let me find out. I know someone in the chat's probably going to say it before me. It is in Round Rock, Texas. Round Rock. What's up, Mr. Taint? I'm just reading his name in the chat, guys. Yeah, it's just outside of Austin, right? Round Rock. North Austin. It's kind of like here in Sacramento. Sacramento, there's all kinds of like cities that outside of the state you might consider Sacramento, but they're real close by, like Roseville, Rocklin, Folsom, Elk Grove. Like all those areas are just really close to Sacramento, so everyone else would see it as Sacramento. What's up, Neil Soloway? What's going on? Welcome, welcome. Looks like Fedor's got an open shot on this two ball with automatic position on the three. Looks like he had to. Did he have to jump that ball? I looked away. It sounded like he had to jump it. It looked like he had an open shot, but maybe the four was just barely in the way. At any rate, he drains it. Fedor is not with Q-Tech anymore. That is correct. He's playing with Triple 60. They own Viking Q's, White Carbon. He says he really likes the equipment he's playing with right now. They're also working on a prototype jump cue that Federer plays with currently, which is really interesting because he says that the back portion of the cue, the jump cue, has a bunch of different options for the length, right? So you can have one that's like this long and kind of heavy. You can have one that's real short and kind of light. So for different types of jumps and different distances, depending on like how high you need to get the ball, you know, you have different weighting in the cue, which is really cool. Yo, Kevin Sandoval, welcome to the stream, buddy. Scott C, what up? If he's straight in here and the eight ball's on the rail, I wonder what he does. Looks like he's got a slight angle he could punch. Yeah, wow, he punched all the way above the eight. How expensive are his cues? Viking cues are what would I say? The price range is similar to many other cue makers. I mean, the price range can be anywhere from fairly affordable to quite expensive. So I don't know about his cues in particular. And the 9 foot does find gravity. I'm just going to look through the bracket, let you guys know what other names have showed up to the tournament. I probably set it up where we can scroll through together. Let me get it set up here. Here we go. Looks like we've got Roland Garcia. Wow, a lot of locals playing. Federer. Mark Estiola. He's probably about to break right now, guys, so I'm going to go back to the game. I'll continue scrolling. Oh, it looks like it's alternate break format, huh? Alternate break format. Lazaro Martinez is down there. He's a Texas native. Stellar young adult junior player. If you've never heard of that kid, keep an eye on him through this tournament. He'll run deep for sure. Plays as close as you can get to being pro level without being world class. Plays real good. Vitaly Patsura is there. Nicky Kraus. Shane Van Boning. Actually looks like a fairly soft field as far as pros go. Very, very interesting. Ahaha, Federer in the chat. Says, I could play with a broomstick, but why would I when I can play with the best equipment? That's right, baby. I played with a white carbon shaft last week. I was really impressed. Really impressed. It's for being carbon fiber, it feels quite soft. Not meaning that it's not stiff, but just the way that the shaft vibrates, it's very soft on the impact. So you don't, and it's very, very low deflection. So soft meaning like wood is soft compared to carbon fiber. In my opinion, that's what it felt like. I only got to play with it for like 5 minutes, but it's a good shaft. Kind of digging this song right now and the music. I wonder how the back and neck is feeling. He just had stem cell therapy done. He's been having some neck pain for a while, and it is structural. And usually stem cell therapy can help with some structural issues. Fingers crossed that he's feeling better. And that it'll only get better as time goes on. Actively chatting in your own live stream during a match is pretty boss. I like that. How old is he? Fedor's 23 now, right, guys? I don't ask him about things like that often as time goes on. I met him first when he was 21. He's got to be 23 right now, right? I mean, we do have Google at our fingertips. 23 years old. Look at that cue ball. Look at how easy he just punches it across the table. Perfect speed with barely any angle. There you go. 2-0 and breaking. Guys, I'm going to leave you alone for just a few minutes. I got to step out of the booth for a second. I'm going to go make some coffee. that, guys. How many games did I miss? It took a lot longer than I thought it would. Anyone in the chat know if the score has changed by one game or two games? Let me know in the chat. I'll get the scoreboard updated. It took like three times longer than I thought it would. Fedor got one. It's 3-0. Thank you, guys. Rock and roll. I gotta love it. I love it that all the regular names that I recognize are the ones to pipe in first. I was watching this guy, Koi, warm up. And he can dab it. I mean, I don't know if he's a run-out player or not. I didn't have a chance to see him, like, his consistency. But, I mean, he can make some shots. He can move the cue ball. I wonder what he'll do with this shot, though. I mean, honestly, I'm such a fish. I'll send the cue ball to the nine, baby. Never do that, guys. Never do that. I just think it's so fun. Send the cue ball, like, three times back and forth behind the five and three. Yo, Sean Hanna, what's up? Yeah, don't forget to click the like button, guys. If you're having a good time, if you're liking the action, click that like button. We only got 44 likes, 500 people watching. Almost 500 people. Ooh, did you see the speed? The speed he hit that ball with? He was sending it at the nine. He was sending it. You know? I mean, he effectively accomplished the same thing because he fluked it in the side, but whenever you go at it with that speed, you're always just trying to, you know, get fortunate. Three to zero games in just 20 minutes. That's actually kind of slow for Fedor. I have a video on my channel on Post Up. He won seven games against another pro, Oscar Dominguez, in 27 minutes. Played perfect. It was a perfect set. He didn't run a seven pack, but when he played safe, he got ball in hand, you know? When he broke the balls and made a ball, he ran out. I think he had five breaking runs in that set. We tried to miss that one. Kind of spit it to the left-hand face of the pocket. I don't know if you guys saw that. The nine ball on the rail, instead of sliding straight down the rail into the pocket, kind of did this. It was on the rail, and it kind of did that into the facing and went. Breaking from the box at this event. One ball goes high. Wing ball doesn't find the pocket. I think it's a dry break. Dry break, boys. It is. And now your boy Koi is kicking at the one. I think you got a kick here. I don't think you push here. Not against Fedor. I'm not pushing against Fedor. The kick isn't bad. There's traffic everywhere. There's a lot of chances to get relatively safe. Ignoring the fact that you're playing against the Ghost. And he's probably going to wreck you if he gets any look at anything. Speed was decent. I think hitting it a little thicker would have been nice instead of catching the edge of the ball. Like this rolling through to guarantee the angle on the two and take the seven out of play for the bridge. Push to a jump as a flex, except Fedor would just jump it in. Fedor would just make the jump. He's the only guy on the planet that you, like, if you think you have an advantage pushing to a jump shot and you're going to get the ball back and be able to jump, it's like one of the only guys on the planet that you're pushing to a disadvantage every time. Have we asked Fedor recently how his neck is feeling? No, we haven't. I'm planning on doing that in the post-match interview. Wow, with the check outside. Look at that. Oh, Vince says, I'm saying push to the jump as a flex, like you're saying you're better at jumping. Yeah, sure. Yeah, I'm pushing to a jump just to disrespect the Ghost. The picture perfect run out right here. Greg Thatcher, I didn't like the Ghost at all when I first heard it. For a while. And then someone in the chat explained to me that it's like, no, it's like you're playing the Ghost. You know, like if you miss, you lose. And in that instance, I think it's very fitting. It's a very good nickname. Like you're playing the nine ball Ghost right now. It's mad respect in that nickname. When you think about it that way. You know, Odium, I think with I'm going to ask him about it, but I think with stem cell therapy, I think the effects take a couple months for the effects to, like, really, like, the benefits to really fully take hold. I could be wrong about that, though. I'm probably wrong about it, but I listen to the Joe Rogan podcast fairly regularly, and he talks about stem cell stuff on there, because he's had stem cell therapy, and I think I remember him saying something to that effect, but I'm not sure. Koi with a dry break. Cue ball was headed for the scratch. Did he make the seven with the cue ball? No. There is a full table jump here that's quite dangerous, but I don't think that Koi's going to shoot at it. Jackie Tucker, we're racing to seven. It's on the scoreboard. I know it's rather small. Nah, it's because he's pale as a ghost. Okay. Dude, you guys are hilarious. It's so fun hanging out with you guys. Well, the sick part here is the two rail kick into the one is covered by the five, meaning you can't make the three. You don't have any odds there. Pushing out to here's not going to do a lot of good for you. I'm pretty sure Fedor can make this ball, and if he doesn't, he probably leaves you safe because he's going to play the cue ball right up here. He's going to play the cue ball up here-ish, right? It lays fairly natural. Maybe you run into the three. I don't know. He does run into the three. Does he get to the other side of the two? Little jelly baby. The sheer calculations. Hey, Brandy Beckett, welcome to the chat, girl. Brandy, I'm doing great. Doing real good. I got my coffee. I got, it's Saturday. Hanging out with you guys, it's always fun. Is he looking at... You can't get to the two that way. You can't get to the two that way because to get to the right spot on the rail here to hit the two, you got to go through the six and the three. It doesn't go. The only way you get to the two that way is like this. And then how do you get a rail? No, that's through the six ball. You can't go that way. I think one of the only kicks here is right here. And it is bloody... narrow. This is okay, I guess. I don't know if it gets there. How are you going to get a rail? I don't like it. Because if you hit hard enough to get a rail, you lose all your control. Koi is in a bad spot right here. Ooh. So close. He's like, okay, I guess I'll just go sit down for another rack. Yeah, Moritz was here last night. He should be here today, I think. I heard that the kid Adrian was going to be barking at him a little bit, or maybe his road partner. What's Koi's Fargo? That's a good question. Six, three, four. He's a solid player, guys. Solid player. I mean, it just goes to show you how good. How good Fedor and these other guys play. It's silly. On the hill. And breaking. Okay, I gotta change this song. I can't take it seriously. Oh, the song is literally called Jungle. It is literally called Jungle. Nice. Okay, I'll ask him, Brandy, if I remember. One ball goes high again. Wing ball doesn't find the hole. Does he fluke another one? Doesn't look like it, guys. Now, Coy, you've been in your chair and had no real open shot for the last six games.
Did I not change the score?
Oh, yeah, no. I did. For the last six games, now you just got to make a full table precision stroke shot. Not like, I don't mean stroke meaning you got to stroke the ball. I mean the stroke has to be very precise to pocket this ball. Settle the nerves. Good morning, Bonnie Blakesley. And Man R, what's going on? Real good shot. Real good shot. Okay, three ball now in Never Never Land over there. How the hell are you going to do something with this three ball, Coy? Show us something good. Draw to the other side of it and shoot the three ball in the same pocket. You ready, guys? Give it to him one time. No dice, and he's not even in a good spot to play safe from. You might be able to get the cue ball behind the seven here. Off the side of the three. I can't really tell what angle you'll be coming off the three, though. Because the three's close to the six, you can use the six to make sure the three doesn't move much, and then you just send the cue ball behind the seven, I think. Unless he's too far below the three, then that becomes very difficult. Divine Swine. Whose name? My name? Collins. My name is Collins. Collins Newey. I mean, you're never shooting the combo unless it lays dead perfect. Do you hear someone in the... I don't know if you guys could hear it, but someone in the room just said, I would try to thin it and put the cue ball behind the seven. You guys probably couldn't hear it because of my music. I don't like going this way with the cue ball. What are you trying to accomplish here? Oh, clever. Clever girl. Didn't really work out, though. You're telling me, Snooker. What's up, buddy? Fedor's just chatting it up with the rail right now. He is jumping this four ball. He's going to try to land on the three here, guys. This is a hell of a jump shot. Oh my. Wow. That is sick. Not only to land in the appropriate location to make good contact with the three, but then you make the ball and somehow you make it past the seven into the corner. How does that happen? That's. Well, we're going to see Coy play some pool. Got to look at the glass half full. I like the way the guy, I like this guy's elbow position and his wrist position and all that stuff. Looks real clean. Looks like his alignment is quite nice. Ooh, he lost his cue ball here. He did not need to put outside spin on that ball. Oops. Wow, real nice shot. Real nice shot by Coy. Let's see Coy break and run one in the next game. What do you think, guys? I think he's capable. Oh. He'll be fine. Shake it off. Play the eight up in the corner. Well, the side's fine, too. If you play it in the corner, you don't have to move the cue ball as much. What's going on with my TV? Is everything okay? Yeah, everything's good. We're good. Real nice speed control from Coy over here. Wins the game. Look at the celebration. Let's go. Let's go, Coy. I got one. Woohoo. Woohoo. Oh, man, I just realized my camera's been facing the wrong way this whole video. We're going to live with it. Yo, Jason Foster, what's up, buddy? Dude, I love that the rail... Can you guys hear the rail? Can you hear the chick on the rail and the guy next to her that are hooting and hollering? Because it's funny. The problem is if you can't hear the rail, I can't turn it up much because then you could hear the venue music. Nice. I'm glad you can hear it. That's good. What are you talking about, Snooker? We're in Texas. This event is in Texas. Well, we got to talk so we don't hear the venue music right now. Song is changing. It's definitely some super pop music on their jukebox right now. Missable shot here, obviously. So he plays safe. And he's going to leave our boy Coy with an opportunity to snooker him with the two ball. It looks like it lays decently to use the two ball for cover. SVB is playing in this event. Ooh, he let the cue ball go. Let the cue ball go. And then Fedor comes up short. Fedor comes up short. Oh my God, you might play the carom here. If you got enough of the one ball, he might look at it. No, he's not looking at it. Apparently does not have enough of the one ball. Let's see if he jacks up and winds up at it. No, he's rolling the ball. No carom. No fun. And this isn't quite a sellout. Ooh, the 7 comes into play. What do you do here? What do you do here? What about kicking off the short rail down here so that you can have odds to make the one in the side? He might even be able to see the one from here. I can't tell. No, he can see the one. Here we go. Oh, he was going after it. And he's going to leave Koi another opportunity to run out here. Dang, that jukebox is loud. Sorry, guys. I've got to turn the venue music or the venue volume down. That jukebox is real loud.
Macaroni cup. Macaroni and the chicken strips.
Oh no. Oh no. It's probably going to be night-night, boys. Got to get Skype ready. I'm going to get the preemptive Skype. Are you a drill guy? Specific drills. Very specific drills. I don't like just drills for the sake of doing drills. Okay, I knew someone was going to have to make some kind of joke like that, cry now, laugh later, and I'm not surprised it was you, honestly. All right, for the match. And we're on to round 3, boys and girls. Fedor takes this race to 7. Little photo op moment. Gotta like it. Gotta like it. Fedor's probably gonna call me any minute now. Holy crap, that's loud, guys. Sorry. Yo, let me mute my music real quick.
Sure.
And we're in. What's up, buddy?
What's up?
How's it going out there? How's the neck feeling?
Good. I mean, it's not that I had, huge injury or something. It's just the pain that was bothering me for the last 2 years, and I felt like it was a good time to take care of it now. I can wait for another year or two, and then it would be too late.
Right.
I don't want that to happen. So yeah, I did 2 injections of stem cells in both of the sides of my traps muscles.
Uh-huh.
And they did an IV with stem cells too, and it's going to take 3 to 5 weeks before I feel anything. Hopefully, okay. It's going to make a difference.
Okay, yeah, because I'd mentioned that in the chat because people were asking if you were feeling better already, and I said I'm pretty certain that it does take like a month to 2 months for you to really feel something. So, yeah, I'll be interested to see how that goes for you over the next few weeks.
Yeah. I mean, I've heard only good reviews. A lot of athletes, UFC fighters, some football players, even Aaron Rodgers. He went to the same clinic and did the same thing when he had that injury in the beginning of the season. I met the owner, Brigham. He's a really, really knowledgeable guy. He knows what he's doing. I watched a lot of his podcasts. And Joe Rogan is also into that thing. He actually was the one that hooked me up with those guys. So, yeah, hopefully it works and hopefully it helps. And hopefully I'll definitely meet again there.
Yeah. Yeah, fingers crossed for that one. I wish you the best. How are the conditions out there? You're feeling good on the table, and obviously you played pretty good in that set.
Yeah, I played good, and the jump cue actually is something that we already almost finalized with triple 60, and as you can see, it jumps pretty good.
Yeah. That jump that you made where you landed on the three. And then
I can't believe I scratched it.
I can't believe you went past the seven. How'd you make it past the seven? I have no idea. That's crazy.
Well, that's something that you will see soon when we launch that product. It's gonna be sick.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Yeah. I feel really, really confident about the jump cue. We're still working on the plank cue and the break cue, but jump cue will be the first cue we're launching, so.
Nice.
That's something that I'm really proud of already, and it's going to be nice.
I'm personally looking forward to hitting some with. I'm sure a couple of the guys around here will get one, so it'll be fun. What about? It looks like the field. How many players did they get out there? It looks like they got maybe 90 players. Do you know?
Yeah, they didn't get a full field. They were planning to have 128 players, and it usually is always full, and full of good players. This time it's not as strong, the field, and it's not full. I guess it's just because of too many tournaments going on right now, and
people taking a break before Vegas, probably. You think traveling, or just not wanting to travel extra before Vegas or something, maybe?
Yeah, I guess, or just too many tournaments. Like,
yeah,
he was playing in that Louisiana tournament. He's usually always here because he lives in Texas. I think he lives in Houston. But I think he's flying back home, or just tired of playing, or it's not like a world championship tournament that you have to go to. It's just a warm up event before. I mean, I take it as a warm up event before big tournaments. Just something to keep me busy and being strong.
Yeah, especially if you got guys. I mean, it looks like in this event you've got what? Roland Garcia, SVB, Mark can play.
No, I don't know. I mean, there's still four or five guys that play really, really good. I mean, Vitaly's here.
Vitaly's there, yeah.
Miki, Roland, and Mark Estiola. Mark Estiola is actually who I play next, probably on the stream table, Pool Action TV. Stream table is probably going to cover that match.
Yeah.
There's still a lot of guys that you can lose to, especially races to seven.
Right. All right. Well, cool. Yeah, you heard it from Fedor, and it's the typical thing, actually, because Pool Action TV is covering this event. I know we say it a lot. Go check them out if you want to see all the major matchups as the tournament is going forward. So,
did you actually see another guy commented and said, I can play with a broomstick?
I did see your response, too. That
Well, go find that guy and tell him to jump a ball with a broomstick.
Yeah. Yeah. Right on. I like it. All right, cool. Well, just keep make sure you're subscribed so you can see if we go live again. I'm assuming you're playing all day today, right? They're planning on getting
probably,
down to
probably they're trying to play us back to back to back. So
yeah,
we'll be in touch, Collins.
Okay, cool. Sounds good. We'll see you guys.